Wendy, I thought the sofa got you.
No, it was all right. Came out the other side and jumped.
Oh, well, what's the matter with him?
Oh, he went into a coma.
Oh, well, all right, just dump him down there somewhere.
Earthquakes and cyclones on bikes. Out in the precinct, people are openly weeping as they search for relatives beneath piles of frozen, pre-packed offal. The authorities say there is no cause for alarm.
Stupid woman, it's just propaganda.
And the events were caused by severe meteorological conditions in the channel.
The weather? The bloody weather? Well, what about the snakes?
Well, I'm just glad they died as soon as they hit the floor.
Yeah, but what about them?
It was probably an aeroplane, Colin.
It wasn't an aeroplane, Wend. An aeroplane's big with wings and propellers. You wouldn't get many passengers inside one of them, would you?
You know what I mean, you stupid prat. They probably fell out of an aeroplane when they were on their way to a bleeding zoo.
Oh, I see. I see. They fell out of an aeroplane en route to a safari park, did they? As well, they fell in through the ceiling, did they? There's 14 bloody floors above us, Wend.
But the window's open, Colin. Freak up the wind, yeah.
Oh, I see. I see, the asps blew in through the window en route to Longleat, did they? I must have missed that, Wend. I must have missed that because my eyes were full of liver.
The Armageddon scenario is now in operation. Phase 2 is complete. Begin phase 3.
Yeah, but what about the ice? What about the plants? I mean, but what about Mrs. Maynard? What about the sofa?
What about them, Colin? You tell me.
Are you receiving?
Hello?
Right, Martin, look, I'm scared. It's not true what they said on the telly, you know, about there being no cause for alarm. I'm alarmed. I'm very alarmed.
Colin, this thing is big. Bigger than all of us.
Yeah, like you standing on a chair.
No, Colin, bigger than that.
Oh, he means like the government or something, Colin.
No, Wendy, bigger than the government.
Well, like the government standing on a chair.
Jesus Christ, Colin, I think you're losing your grip on reality.
Reality? What's reality, Martin? I mean, how do we know that any of this is real, eh? How do you know that this stool's real? Come on, it's hard, but how do you know it's real? How do you know it doesn't vanish when we leave the room? How do you know the stool's real?
You're testing!
Just shut up, please. I'm trying to have a radio conversation.
Yeah, all right. Radio conversation.
Yeah,
I'll see you later down the station, yeah?
Okay,
bye.
Yeah, Ma, I'm on riot duty, yeah? Apparently, people are forming themselves into vigilante groups, yeah? And they're storming the outpatient department of the hospital for paracetamols. There's been a big outbreak of migraines.
Yeah, and you know where the migraines are coming from, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah, Sarge says it's a virus, like that disease you get from dog shit.
Dog shit?
It's not dog shit, Wendy. It's the CIA.
It's not the CIA, Martin. It's monsters from outer space.
Look, I don't care if it's the CIA, if it's dog shit, or it's bloody boggly monsters. I'm going to be late. You give us a lift down the station,
Yeah,
Mark?
Of course,
please. Do you think he'll be all right?
Well, he'll be all right, all right. He's probably got two hearts and four stomachs, hasn't he?
Wendy, I want you to help me. I've got this case. It's important. I want to keep your eyes and ears open down the station, all right?
What?
Wendy, I want you to help me. Here. Look at this.
Oh, wow. Oh, it's lovely. Thank you.
No, Wendy. This case could explain the exploding butcher and a lot more.
You know, I love the smell of liver in the morning.
It's true. Danzig's here. It's already begun.
Let's go get the bastard. The case. The case. Now I remember everything. I even remember what happens next.
Ralph? Ralphie? What's happened to the office, Ralph?
I'm about to undertake initial tests on sample specimens for traces of unknown radiation. So I'm going over to the microscope now. have been over to the microscopes, but have had to come back to turn this off.
So, Shauna, things were pretty weird around your place too last night, were they?
Yeah, I suppose they always are, with Jack being the way he is.
Have you seen the Lenner Aviation book around anywhere?
Put a cap on, will you, Shauna?
Martin, could you do a rerun on this egg stain? The defence claims that the woman was nowhere near the farm.
Yeah, I'll get Shauna onto it straight away. Shauna, ever done an egg stain? The litmus paper's in the top drawer.
Martin, what are these?
Those? Specimens. That's a cupboard, Shauna, the drawer.
What specimens?
Liver, prawns, rubber plant.
Not company specimens.
Well, yeah. No.
Martin, I've told you before, company time and equipment is for company work. We are not here to indulge your whims. Your political interests...
What I'm working on isn't a whim. It's life or death. It's politics. It's far-reaching. It's all around us. It's... Christ, look, we're running out of time. We've got to get to the bottom of it.
Bottom of what?
The Americans. The strange events. The unknown radiation. It's all tied up. I mean, you saw what happened last night.
Look, Martin, I don't think this is either the time or the place for upsetting Shauna. Cheer up, Shauna. It's not the end of the world.
Yeah, but it might be.
Sorry I'm late, Cole. It's absolute chaos out there. It's like the end of the world. What on earth happened here last night?
That's what I intend finding out, Aunt. Have you brought the books?
Yes, I have. They're here.
Oh, yeah.
All about.
It's recurrent themes, Anthony. Recurrent themes.
Oh. Can we go to the pub now, then?
No liver. No killer porn cocktails, no sofa. I rest my case. What do you want to drink, Colin?
Look, Martin, why do you always have to take everything so literally?
Because I'm a realist, Colin. You have to be in my job. Look, I did a science degree, and one thing that taught me was... Well, it wasn't a pure science degree, but it was science-based. I did it in the Anglo-European school with art subsidiaries. So I'm broad-based, Colin. I'm broad-based. So look, when...
You've forgotten what you're on about, haven't you?
No, I haven't.
Yes, you have.
Cut the mind games, Colin. Just get on with it. I can't sit around here all day talking about third-rate fiction. I've got important things to do.
The weather may be waves all fine.
The authorities are lying when they say it was the weather. True or false? True. Two, these books all contain disaster sequences written in recurrent imagery. Giant animals, malicious plants, nature fighting back. Classic Armageddon scenarios. True or false?
I'll take your word for it.
Three, there's a similarity between what happened in Middleford last night and the events described in these books. Not literally, but in spirit. True or false?
Yeah, well, all right. Yeah, But so what? I mean, it doesn't mean anything. We can't conclude anything from it, can we?
Yes, we can. What it means, what we can conclude, is that the aliens who are attacking us are familiar with our culture. Familiar! Culture! Books, films, they've seen them. They've decided to attack us in ways we've been writing about in books for years. Rain, crabs, crocodiles. Only we've got to accept that they've got a sense of humour. I mean, why do people always presume that other life forms won't understand humour, eh? Eh? Humorous, but dangerous too. I mean, who knows what may come next? Zombies, killer cress, invasion of the Gylerons.
Colin, you ought to see a doctor.
Are you feeling now, then?
Much better. Thanks for Mars, by the way.
Oh, you guessed it was me that left it for you.
Well, it'd hardly be in colour now, would it?
No. Hardly.
No, I think that was the nicest candy bar I've ever been given.
I think a Mars is a Mars is a Mars.
No, it's a very special Mars. I think you're pretty special, too. Don't know how special.
Don't stop it.
No, seriously. I'm in love with you.
No, I am. I am, too. No, not you. Me. No, you. Oh, I can't explain. It's difficult.
I can't wait to see their faces when they read the letter I wrote to the Chronicle.
Look, Martin, for the last time, you've got to listen to me. I know what's going on in Middleford, and believe me, things are going to get worse, much worse. Look, I'm leaving town. I've got a car, 5-day supply of water, and a big box of satsumas. There's room for you and Wendy. There isn't room for anyone else, though, because I've got the satsumas on the other seat. Look, I'm planning to leave at 15:30 hours. I want you to meet me by the big fluffy...
Colin! Zombies! The living dead! They're walking the earth!
You bastard!
Basically, well, Julie always says that I'm quite an insecure person. I don't really think I am, actually. It's... Isn't nature wonderful?
Wendy, there's something I want you to do for me.
What?
It's vitally important. Our lives may depend on it. What I want you to do is this. Will you do it?
But why? Why is it so important?
I can't tell you right now. Later. You do trust me, don't you?
You know I do.
It's perfectly safe, and there's no need to panic. However, for your own safety, no one will leave Middleford until further notice. Roadblocks have therefore been set up on strategic points on the Middleford Ring Road. You are advised to go home and stay home. Otherwise, last orders may really mean last orders.
Thank you. situation at the hospital is now well under control. They are denying that a further riot reported in the central shopping precinct is also due to the so-called migraine mania, and are designating it a copycat riot. A police spokesman said that anyone can fake a headache. Further reports of fat blokes on bikes.
To bring this country to its knees. Why can't you get a job? There's loads of work around if only you'd look for it. Your father was a bum, your mother was a bum, and you're a bum. Look, and I dare say that you've got a little doggy at home, so I guess that makes it a bum too.
Why didn't you stop them, Colin?
I couldn't, Mark. There was about half a dozen of them.
Well, what did they look like? Were they wearing American uniforms?
I don't know. I didn't see them. I was hiding in the kitchen.
Jesus Christ. The case!
I don't know what you're moaning about anyway, Mark. They broke my Kendall mint cake. It wouldn't have happened if it hadn't been in your flat. By rights, you ought to buy me a new bar, you know. Still, let's call it quits, eh? Look, Mark, I'm going. You're making a big mistake staying here, you know. It's gonna get worse tonight, much worse. I know. I've read the books. Goodbye, Martin.
You're there. It's gone. I can't talk over the phone.
Why not?
Because the phone might be... Oh, I better not say. Let's just say it's gone.
Martin?
Yes, I'd like to order a taxi, please, for...
What?
At Natural. I'd like an alarm call in the morning, please.
What for?
Wendy, the cat is out of the bag. The bag, yeah?
Oh, you mean the bank?
Yeah.
Oh, I understand now.
Martin, you mean the bank?
Yeah. Someone's nicked the case and I'm panicking. See you later.
Never told a lie in my life and now look what you made me do. Martin's one of my best friends. What's I important about this bloody case anyway? Oi! What's your name? What's your bloody name?
I'm sorry, Wendy. But none of that matters now. The waiting's over. Observe.
Anything to you?
Yeah. You've got a dental appointment at 3 o'clock tomorrow.
Is
No. There are no children in Middleford.
Look, we're in danger. It's all to do with the bits in the books, you know, that me and Anthony were doing at work this morning by the plants. Armageddon scenarios, Wend. Look, I want you to meet me in an hour down the...
As experts, I really do think we've got a duty to do
something. I understand the importance of what you're saying. I was as scared as everyone else by what happened in this town last night. But you must appreciate my situation.
Yes, but...
I'll tell you what I'll do, Martin. This is strictly off the record, you understand? I'm not giving you official permission, but go ahead with your research, and I'll turn a blind eye to it.
Are you all right, Professor?
It's all right. It's just a migraine. As I was saying, do you have a cigarette, Martin?
Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
What do I do if I want to pee? Well, go on my own. Who's there? Wendy? Who is it? Wendy! Got a satsuma, Wend? Wendy! It's me, it's Cole. Wend!
What?
They came.